Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be spending some time on the AE Tekron 7224 linear power amplifier. This amplifier can be used for a variety of different applications, including EMC testing. We'll go ahead and we'll start by walking through a little bit about the unit. Then we'll spend some time on how the unit can be configured using the switches in the rear of the unit. And then finally, we'll connect the 3110A waveform generator to our 7224 and take a brief look at a few waveforms. Now let's go ahead and let's take a little closer look at the front of our 7224. Here you'll find the front of our 7224 linear power amplifier. Let's go ahead now and let's start from the left side of the unit and let's work our way right. All the way on the far left, you'll notice the off-on switch. Working our way right, you will see we have our gain control knob, and you can see right there we have it going from 0 all the way to 100. Just to the right of that, you will see our enable and stop push buttons. Just to the right of both those push buttons, you will see a series of LEDs. Those are going to be run, ready, standby, and then finally stop. Just to the right of those series of LEDs, you will see our reset switch. And then to the right of that switch, a series of fault status indicators. That should just about complete the front of our 7224. Now let's go ahead and let's take a look at the backside of our linear power amplifier. Here you'll find the backside of the 7224. Let's go ahead and let's start from the left side of the unit and let's work our way right. On the far left, we have our AC supply input. Just to the right of that, we have our output terminal. As we work our way right, you will see our BNC input connector. And then just above that, the DIP switches. To the right of that BNC connector, you will see our input selector switch and our terminal block input connector. Finally, all the way on the right, you will see the interlock connector. Let's go ahead now and let's spend a little time looking at the switch on the rear of the unit. Here you'll find the DIP switches, which can allow for different configuration settings to be selected. There are 8 different switches that can be moved either up or down to reflect the different configurations. You will notice that we only have one switch in the down position right now, and that's switch number 5, which is electronic gain matching. This switch is placed in the up or on position when there are multiple amplifiers used in a parallel configuration. When you receive the equipment either from the factory or if you're renting it from us here at Transient Specialist, this should be the configuration you see in the DIP switches. Let's go ahead now and let's take a quick look at the user manual, which provides different information on the switch settings. There's also a quick reference on the back on top of the unit you can also reference as well. Here's page 17 from the user manual, which focuses on the switch configurations and settings. You'll see the factory default settings are in red, which shows how we have ours configured in the video today. We have all the switches in the up position, except for that switch number 5, which is electronic gain matching. You can also reference the diagram on the back side of the 7224, which provides a very similar overview of the different DIP switch settings. If you want more information on the variety of settings that are available, you can check out pages 18 and 19, which provide a little more in-depth description of the different capabilities. What I'll do is I'll put a link in the description below that'll take you to the user manual, and if you want more information, you can check those out. Let's go ahead now and let's connect our 3110A waveform generator to our 7224, and let's take a brief look at a few waveforms. We just connected our 3110A to the 7224. We added a 10-volt sine wave, and we have our gain set at 10%. As we increase the gain, we should see an increase in that waveform. Let's go ahead now and let's slowly increase the gain to about 15%. Perfect. And if you look at the screen now in the oscilloscope, you should be seeing that increase. The nice part about this system is you can program a variety of different waveforms using the 3110A, making your own custom sequences. Now let's go ahead and let's take a look at DC quickly. We've set a DC voltage of 5 volts. Now let's go ahead and let's increase the gain from 20 to 30%, and we should see an increase. Great, just like that. We appreciate everyone's time as we walk through a little bit about the AE Tekron 7224. We started by walking through the front and the back of the unit, then to the different configuration switches, and then finally how the gain setting can be used. We appreciate everyone's time, and please keep us in mind if you ever need to rent any of the equipment used in today's video.